We speak about respiratory burst, respiratory burst, or other name oxidative burst, oxidative burst. So respiratory burst or oxidative burst. So this is the best way. This is the best way for what? For killing the bacteria. For killing the bacteria. For killing the bacteria. Killing the bacteria. So if there is inhibition of any step of it, leading to increasing the bacterial infection, increase the risk of bacterial infection. So we have here the phagolysosome. Phagolysosome, and this is what? This is the neutrophil cell membrane. Neutrophil cell membrane. So we have six steps. The first one, second, the third, the fourth, fifth, and sixth one. So the first one is what? NADPH oxidase. NADPH oxidase will convert the NADPH into NADB. So if there is deficiency in NADPH oxidase, leading to what? Increase the risk of infection with catalase positive organism. Catalase positive organism like what? سبنا بعض S استافيلوكوكس أوريس S سيريشيا B برخوديريا سبيشيا then B سودوموناس N نوكارديا A أسبرجيلوس. So again catalase positive organism leading to what? So NADPH oxidase deficiency equals chronic granulomatous disease. So we have catalase positive organism like سبنا بعض S استافيلوكوكس أوريس S سيريشيا B برخوديريا سبيشيا B سودوموناس N نوكارديا A أسبرجيلوس. So استافيلوكوكس أوريس سيريشيا برخوديريا سبيشيا سودوموناس N نوكارديا A أسبرجيلوس. So NADPH oxidase will convert NADPH into NADB. Then formation of what? Of superoxide. So this is superoxide. Then the second one is what? Superoxide dismutase. It will form what? H2O2, which is hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide will go in this pathway, plus it will be converted into HCl by addition of chloride. So addition of chloride by what? By the third step. Third step is what? Myeloperoxidase. And this is so important because myeloperoxidase contains the blue-green heme contains pigment that gives the sputum its color. So the green color, the blue-green color, which one is responsible for it? Myeloperoxidase. So myeloperoxidase contains the blue-green color. So myeloperoxidase responsible for the blue-green heme containing pigment. This is asked in the exam. Myeloperoxidase blue-green. So here NADPH oxidase will convert NADPH into NADB. Then superoxide dismutase will convert the superoxide into what? Into H2O2, which is hydrogen peroxide. Then the third step, addition of chloride into the hydrogen peroxide, leading to formation of HCl. Third step, responsibility for what? For myeloperoxidase, the blue green color. Then HCl will cause lysis of the bacteria. Normally the bacteria will defend against H2O2 hydrogen peroxide by what? By bacterial catalase. It will take hydrogen peroxide and convert it into water and oxygen. So bacteria through catalase will defend against anything that will cause lysis for it. So it will defend for itself. It will defend by what? By conversion of H2O2 hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen. So normally H2O2 will cause lysis to the bacteria by what? By addition of chloride to it, leading to formation of HCl by what? By myeloperoxidase, leading to lysis of the bacteria, plus H2O2 hydrogen peroxide will go through the neutrophil cell membrane, so we have here the fourth step, fifth step, then the last one. So the fourth step, the responsibility for catalase glutathione peroxidase, it will convert hydrogen peroxide into water and it will convert GSH into GSSG. So it will convert the glutathione reduced into glutathione oxidized. So it will convert glutathione reduced into oxidized. Then the fifth one is what? Glutathione reductase. I will do the opposite. So I will convert the oxidized form of glutathione into reduced form by glutathione reductase, and I will convert NADPH into NADB. Then what the next one? Glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. Glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. I will convert again NADB into NADPH and I will convert glucose 6-phosphate into 6-phosphogluconolactone. So we have these steps. These steps for what? For lysis of the bacteria. So phagolysosome. So if there is any abnormality in this pathway, inhibition of NADPH and NADPH oxidase, for example, elevation the risk of what? Of the bacterial catalase positive bacteria. سيبنا بعض. S. Staphylococcus aureus. S. Serratia. B. Brachyderia sebacea. B. Pseudomonas. N. Nocardia. A. Aspergillus. So again, respiratory burst, oxidative burst, it will involve what? Activation of phagocyte NADPH oxidase complex, in neutrophil and monocytes, which will utilize O2. O2 as a substrate, and it will play an important role in immune response. Rapid release of reactive oxygen species. So what are the three reactive oxygen species here? Now we have H2O2, which is hydrogen peroxide, and we have O2 superoxide. So we have superoxide and hydrogen peroxide, and we have the HOCl, which is hypochloride. So we have superoxide and hypochloride, HOCl, and we have hydrogen peroxide, H2O2. These are called reactive oxygen species. So NADPH will play a role in both the creation and neutralization of ROS, reactive oxygen species. So we have here myeloperoxidase contains what? Blue-green pigment. So blue-green myeloperoxidase, heme containing pigment. So NADPH will play a role in both the creation and neutralization of reactive oxygen species. So here we will speak about the phagocytes of patients with what? Chronic granulomatous disease. It will utilize H2O2 generated by invading organism. So it will utilize H2O2 generated by invading organism. How? We said that H2O2 will be converted by the bacterial catalase into what? Into H2O and oxygen. So it will not destruct the bacteria by the action of catalase, leading to increase the risk of bacteria. So here chronic granulomatous disease will utilize H2O2 generated by invading organism, and it will convert it into reactive oxygen species. So patients are increased risk of infection by catalase positive species like what? Like Sibnabad. S. Staphylococcus aureus. S. Serratia. B. Brachyderia sebacea. B. Pseudomonas. N. Nocardia. A. Aspergillus. So capable of neutralizing their own H2O2. So they will neutralize H2O2 into what? Into water and oxygen. So there is increased susceptibility for catalase positive organism, leaving phagocytes without what? Without reactive oxygen species for fighting infection. So the next one is so important. We have here Pseudomonas aeruginosa. It's characterized by what? By bio بايوسيانين بيجمنت بايوسيانين بيجمنت اتس اسكد ان ذا اكزام بايوسيانين بيجمنت بلو جرين بيجمنت بلو جرين بيجمنت فور وات فور سودوموناس 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 اروجنوزا جينيريتس رياكتيف اوكسجين سبيشيز تو كيل كومبيتين باثوجين ذن اوكسيديتيف بيرست اوكسيديتيف بيرست اور كولد واتر ريسبيراتوري ريسبيراتوري بيرست سو ريسبيراتوري بيرست اور اوكسيديتيف بيرست leads to what releasing of lysosomal enzymes plus we have here lactoferrin lactoferrin is what is a protein that will work by what by iron chelation so this protein found in secretory fluids and neutrophil secretory fluid and neutrophil and it will inhibit microbial growth through iron chelation then the next one we have here interferon alpha beta and gamma interferon alpha beta and gamma so if this is a viral infected cell it will release interferon why to inhibit viral replication to inhibit viral replication to inhibit protein synthesis inhibit protein synthesis plus it will upregulate MHC on its surface to increase the immune response against this cell so again if this is virally infected cell so it will release interferon for what for in down regulation inhibition of protein synthesis so I will inhibit viral replication now plus I will upregulate MHC on its surface to increase the immune response against this cell so we have interferon alpha beta and gamma which is a part for what innate host defense interferons will interfere with both RNA and DNA viruses so cells that's infected with what with a virus will synthesize these glycoprotein they will synthesize interferon alpha interferon beta interferon gamma which will act on local cells leading to priming them from for viral defense by down regulation protein senses to resist potential viral replication so I will inhibit viral replication by release of interferons and by upregulation I will upregulate MHC expression on the surface of the cell to facilitate recognition of infected cell by the immune system leading to increase the immune damage to this cell then also play major role in activating anti-tumor immunity then we have here the most important about interferons we have interferon alpha beta gamma granulomatous so we will study it in immunotherapy we have chronic granulomatous disease you will use what interferon alpha or beta or gamma I will use interferon gamma granulomatous then multiple sclerosis you will use what interferon beta then we have here renal cell carcinoma and malignant melanoma renal cell carcinoma plus hepatitis B and hepatitis C you will use interferon alpha then we have here malignant melanoma and renal cell carcinoma there is another drug for interleukin 2 called what aldesleukin against renal cell carcinoma and melanoma so we have here interferon alpha interferon beta interferon gamma it can be released from what from the virally infected cell or it can be synthesized by technology so if you synthesized alpha so you will use it against hepatitis B hepatitis C and renal cell carcinoma if you synthesized interferon beta you will use it against multiple sclerosis if you synthesize the gamma interferon gamma so granulomatous disease chronic granulomatous disease so we have another recombinant technology for synthesizing interleukin 2 aldesleukin it's against what against renal cell carcinoma plus it's against malignant melanoma so interferons against what hepatitis B Kaposi sarcoma hairy cell leukemia, condyloma, acuminata, and we spoke about each one: renal cell carcinoma, malignant melanoma, multiple sclerosis, chronic granulomatous disease. So adverse effects: flu-like symptoms and depression, neutropenia, myopathy, interferon-induced autoimmunity. So we have adverse effects for it: flu-like symptoms, depression, neutropenia, myopathy, interferon-induced autoimmunity. So if we spoke about the importance of respiratory burst, oxidative burst, so we have what? We have NADPH oxidase deficiency, SIBNA, increase the risk of infection with what? Catalase positive organism, S. Staphylococcus aureus serratia, B. Burkholderia sebacea, B. Pseudomonas, N. Nocardia, A. Aspergillus. Then the myeloperoxidase responsible for blue-green heme containing pigment. Then we have here biocyanine for Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and reactive oxygen species like what? We have hydrogen peroxide, and we have HOCAL, and superoxide. Then we spoke about interferon alpha, beta, and gamma, and the action of them. A virally infected cell will release interferons. This interferon will inhibit viral replication by inhibition of by down regulation of protein senses, so inhibition of protein senses, plus it will upregulate MHC on its surface, leading to recognition of immune cells against these cells. And we spoke about interferon alpha as it's used in what? In hepatitis B and C and renal cell carcinoma, interferon beta, multiple sclerosis, interferon gamma, granulomatous disease, and interleukin 2 for what? Aldesleukin, renal cell carcinoma, and malignant melanoma. And adverse effects for interferons like what? Flu-like symptoms, depression, neutropenia, myopathy, interferon-induced autoimmunity.